Hey, and welcome to the Real Black Hole add-on tutorial that generates black holes. So, after expanding the add-on, there aren't really any options besides the Generate Black Hole button. This is because there are currently no parameters to manage. More options will appear after the black hole is generated. It's crucial to have the Cycles engine set because lensing doesn't work on Eevee. This is what the rough render looked like. Pretty weak, right? To fix this, go to render settings and click automatic settings. If the preview isn't updated, change one of the parameters for a moment like that. Now it looks very realistic, like black hole in Interstellar. When you select the object, a menu with material settings will appear, which is entirely procedurally made. There are quite a few of them, but really, if you don't feel like tinkering with all of them, the settings at the top will grate. The rest of the settings are used to edit the entire volumetric mask. However, with these settings you can make a project more tailored to your needs or make a more realistic animation. It looks really cool. So, this is what the black hole looks like on the black background, and I think it's impressive. However, remember that is a very computer-intensive project. If you click on the black hole, a menu with lensing settings will appear. That is how strongly gravity bends the image. And the last thing is the animation settings tab, where you animate the acceleration disk. You can animate both the mask and the texture. And if that's not enough, you can go back to the material settings and animate more parameters there. Lastly, I'll show you what the project looks like with a star background and random HDRI. I think it looks great and is perfect for animation, rendering or even CGI. If you liked it, there's a link to the add-on in the description. And I'd really appreciate it if you let a like and let me know what do you think of this add-on. I want to mention that this is my first material that I recorded in English, as it's not my native language. So I would be grateful if you let me know how it turned out. Whether I spoke clearly enough and whether I didn't kill the grammar. That's all. Have a great day and see you later.